Now that we have an audio, let's add some animations in our project. Let's start animate the sun. In order to do so, click the layer sun and click add animation. The animation window appears. Here you can name your animation or even just accept the name proposed by Kwik and select the type. For this first animation, let's use linear. The keyframe info shows us the current position of the sun. Anytime you move it, Kwik automatically will save that. But the most important thing here is the end position, as it is a linear animation. So let's move the sun a little bit higher. You can do so, for example, just moving this line, the Y line, meaning that the sun is a little bit higher now. And let's move the sun also close to the Africa name. That's fine here. You could also do that just entering numbers here. The return to start position after play should be used anytime that you decide to have the current layer return to its previous position. It's not the case for the sun, so let's uncheck it. The alpha, again, is just for the end position, so let's keep it as 100% as the sun will always be showing up. The duration is the time from the start to the end position. So let's say the sun will move up from the original position to the end one in 3 seconds. Starts helps you to define if the animation will play as soon as you start the movie, or if it will need to wait until a button starts it. In this case, let's just accept the when page start. The delay also tells Kwik to wait a little bit, a few seconds before to start the animation, or just start it as soon as the movie starts. Let's wait 2 seconds. With that, let's create. As you can see here, the animation sun is already in the project, and the sun came back to its original position. And as I mentioned, you can even say, let's start the sun here and move it from the back of the planes, for example. So, one more. Here we go. Kwik knows that although we changed the original position of the sun, the end position is the one saved. Anytime that you decide to review your animation, you don't need to create it again. Just double click and you see everything here. The next animation is the cloud. So let's click the cloud here and let's animate the cloud. We will still use the linear here, but the only thing that we are gonna do now is to move the X position, the cloud, to off screen. Meaning that, again, the cloud will cross the screen. In this case, we want the cloud to return to its original position when the animation finishes. So you're gonna leave this check here. Also, the duration is gonna be 10 seconds. It's gonna be a slow move across the screen. And at this time, we are gonna use the wait request. Again, when the movie starts, nothing's gonna happen with the cloud. It will be there until something happens. We are gonna tell a button later on what to do with this cloud. Let's create it.